All right, let's talk about the big story today. The president reacting to the revelations in Bob Woodward's new book, Rage. And if we can get to any other items, we shall. Joining me tonight, Democratic strategist Kevin Walling, who is on the right on your screen, the editorial director of the Reactionary Times, Julio Rivera, who's on the left side, both up late with me on the Final Five. Gentlemen, good to see you both tonight.
Hey, Jim, good to be with you.
Hey, Julio, I want to start with you. So this story came out. We knew that there was a book. And look, I've said on the show before, if you can pick one industry that has certainly thrived during the presidency of Donald Trump, it has been the publishing industry, because we have seen so many of these books written, whether it be people who have left the administration or, in this case, Bob Woodward, who is this would be a second book. But at issue were some statements that Woodward said the president made when it came to downplaying the threat of coronavirus months ago. I'm curious what the take has been on from your perspective on this today, because this really has guided the news cycle.
Well, let me tell you something, Jim. You described it as a revelation, and I think it's far from a revelation. He said that this is deadly stuff. I mean, I think his message has been consistent from the very beginning, that this is something that we did have to worry about. You know, so I don't think that that's breaking any new ground. Mm-hmm. The fact of the matter is the president has handled the pandemic from that early point. And let's not forget, when that audio was taken, that was only 2 days after the impeachment inquiry had ended. You know, initially, when there was a travel restriction originally placed, a travel alert in early January, it was described by politicians on the left as a very xenophobic policy. You know, and the Democrats actually even attached, there was a end the travel ban bill that Pelosi was pushing as late as March 10th. So you have to ask yourself, you know, which party has actually been handling the pandemic responsibly?
Well, we know, Kevin, the statements have come out today. We know that Joe Biden has put his statement out saying that he believes that this was information that the White House did not want to get out at that point. And I think one of the questions a lot of people has had is why if this was such a bombshell, why Bob Woodward didn't put this out into the political ecosphere much sooner?
Yeah, it's a good question, Jim. Obviously, I think with any of these books, that they want to sell more books. And obviously, it made for a compelling television. I think it, to your point earlier, is going to capture the news cycle quite a bit. But to Julio's point at the end, you know, when we ask the American people time and time again, who do you trust more in dealing with the coronavirus? It's Joe Biden and the Democrats. And I think what we saw with these tapes released today has only confirmed what we've known for a long time, is that Donald Trump knew just how deadly this pandemic was, especially with regards to young people, as he points out, not just old people. And the fact of the matter that he had this conversation on February 7th and went on to have, I think, over a dozen or so public events, rallies, knowing just how dangerous this coronavirus, this COVID-19 was to the American people, is not just a dereliction of duty. I mean, he was seeking to do harm to his own followers. That's what doesn't make sense to me, is the veneer that he put up. And really kind of covering up the fact that this is a really serious thing, especially for his supporters gathering in public.
When you say, though, seeking to do his supporters harm, what do you mean by that?
I think if you know, as he did privately with Bob Woodward, just how deadly this is, just how deadly it is in through the air, as they talk about in this private phone conversation, and still continue to have these rallies where you're not wearing a mask, where you're not talking about social distancing, again, knowing just how deadly this virus is and subjecting his followers, his supporters to that virus while they are forced to sign a waiver, to attend that event, I think is a really damning indictment of this administration.
You were laughing there for a second, Julio.
Yeah, you know, because this is ridiculous. The president was unfortunately at the mercy of China, which was not giving out a lot of this information. There was conflicting information. Let's do a little review here. As late as January 14th, the World Health Organization was still telling people that the person-to-person communicability was not possible. In late January, Dr. Fauci was out doing media saying that the coronavirus was still something that we didn't have to necessarily worry about. For him to classify it as deadly, you have to look at it in context. The regular seasonal flu
is coronavirus sense, not is deadly. It's and people killed nearly 200 Americans, Julio.
Oh, no, but let me tell you something. When they revised the CDC numbers, only 6% of those deaths were actually as a result of only the coronavirus. So it's not killing people in mass the way that it's portrayed.
Yeah, it's killing
in
people with pre-existing conditions. But there were
the comorbidities alongside of that. And I know that that was something that was certainly a hot-button topic.
I don't think that's a platform you want to run on.
Of course it is, because we're shutting down the economy and destroying, you know, people's lives in America. Millions
because
of bankruptcies,
because this
divorces,
president didn't handle this crisis.
Business.
Because this president, the fact of the matter is, this virus is
not nearly as deadly as it's being played up to be. You know, President Trump gave an off-the-cuff remark that it is deadly, and obviously it is because people have died of it.
Right.
But what you have to take into consideration is look at the way people like Andrew Cuomo have handled it. When you brought a naval hospital ship in there, and they didn't use the naval hospital ship, instead of sending, you know, they were sending people back into nursing homes where people who were vulnerable We're catching the coronavirus and dying. And that's one of the things that led up to the spikes in numbers.
So Julio, we're running out of time here, but I just want to get your take, because you mentioned about the economic angle. And we've seen, in fact, you mentioned New York. It looks like they're going to start reopening indoor dining later this month at 25% capacity. What is the solution? Is there a solution where you can mind the public health but also mitigate any more economic damage here?
Yes, absolutely. You have to do it incrementally, which was the original plan from the beginning. It was supposed to be 2 weeks to flatten the curve, and then we were supposed to start up slowly. There were pockets in America that should have never been closed, because there were counties in this country that didn't have a single case.
Kevin?
I mean, I think you're seeing Democrats out there and the vice president and his campaign saying we've got to do everything safely. He's out back on the campaign trail. Again, with an eye towards social distancing and mask wearing. He is leading by example, and you compare that to the president, who says things in secret, knowing how deadly this is, and is tested regularly, has all the people around him tested regularly. So it's one set of rules for the president and his campaign, and another set of rules for his followers and the American people.
And
I think that's fundamentally wrong.
What was that?
Okay, Julio.
What was that, Julio?
And another set of rules for these rioters that it took 100
days
for Joe Biden to finally condemn.
Okay. I know you want to change the subject, Julio, but we're talking about coronavirus.
Yeah, and so am I.
All right. Gentlemen, thank you both. Julio Rivera, Kevin Wallen, good to see you both. And the Final Five is back after this. Thank you.